When I look back at my first year of uni, there's a lot of regrets that I've made, and one thing I wish I knew more about was finding better deals. So in this video, I'm going to talk about how you as a student can make the most out of the discounts that are available to you. So the first thing I want to talk about are student discounts that you can get from ASOS and MyUniDays. If you're someone that's already quite familiar with online clothes shopping, you're probably quite aware of ASOS already. So if you're a student, you get a 25% off code that you can use throughout the duration of your degree. This is also the same for MyUniDays, except it's not limited to just a single store or an area. What's quite dope about it is that it sort of spans a lot of areas such as fashion, beauty, technology, lifestyle, as well as health. So that's pretty cool. The discounts also are quite different, so they could range from like 5% all the way to 40%, but they sort of sometimes have bundles as well, where you may occasionally encounter deals from Apple, such as if you buy a MacBook, you also get a free set of AirPods. Anyways, I'll leave links down below so it's easier for you guys to search on later on. So this leads on to my second tip, which is bargaining and price matching on tech items. So as a uni student, it's almost impossible to survive without having a laptop with you. What a lot of people don't know is that you can bargain tech items down quite low at places such as JB Hi-Fi and Bingley. I actually used this strategy for both my laptop as well as my phone, which was a huge, huge help to me personally. As a general rule of thumb, I like to begin by bargaining 30 to 40% off the original price, which then sort of gets the sales dude to give you their best price. And then from there on, what you can do is go online on your phone, check the same product and try to find a cheaper price, and then try to lowball him and or price match, and then ask for a further 5% off that price that you found on your phone. So if you have a stingy parent, I recommend you bring him or her along with you to the ride. I got a pretty embarrassing story about 4 to 5 years ago, back when I was in first year. So my dad is quite the stingy person, and at the time I wanted this $1,300 laptop. So what he did was that he started off by lowballing the guy by saying, giving a price of around $800. And for the next 30 minutes, he was pretty much talking to the JB Hi-Fi guy, saying how much better Bingley was. And the guy eventually sort of gave up because he couldn't be bothered dealing with my dad, and he was starting to cause a pretty massive scene around the area. So we eventually were able to settle down around $950, which is still amazing, still if you think about it. So that's about $1,300 minus $950, so $350. So yeah, that's a huge deal. Even though it was kind of embarrassing, it was quite entertaining at the same time. On that note, I also recommend you check out Ozbargain, where you can see a lot of cheap tech deals as well as the occasional cheap deals on food, such as KFC and pizza. So let me show you how easy this is. So all you need to do is just go to the cheeky search bar at the top right corner, search up whatever you want. So let's say Pizza Hut, and it should pop up. Yeah, so you got all your like juicy stuff on the side. Yeah, free pizzas, free sides for $34.95. So yeah, it's a pretty good deal. What a bargain.
So I'll leave the links down below for you guys to check out as well. Okay, so continuing on from Ozbargain and Cheap Eats, I suggest you guys check out the apps Eat Club and The Fork. So during uni, you'll probably go on quite the number of dates, and if your cute date has expensive taste and you sort of want to show off your moolah, you should definitely check out those apps down below. What's awesome about those apps is that you'll occasionally see fat deals for expensive restaurants that range from 20% to up to 60%, which is kind of insane. So that's a great way to sort of BS to your date that you're kind of loaded. The next piece of advice is more targeted towards first years who are entering uni for the first time. So I suggest that you guys wait for your first lecture and before buying your textbooks. For most cases, your lecturers will tell you that you might not necessarily need textbooks for the course, and that the slides are sufficient enough. I suggest you guys check out Textbook Exchange on Facebook, where a lot of people sell their old textbooks for less than half the price. Even though the editions might be a bit older, you're pretty much paying for the exact same content at a cheaper price. It just looks a bit older. And finally, I suggest you cook your own food whenever you can. So when you go to uni for the first time, you end up realizing that uni food is extremely overpriced. Even if you don't necessarily agree, once you see your own weekly expenditure on the food, you realize it sort of racks up. Also, be on the lookout for free food on campus. Sometimes you can see free food on Facebook. You just need to follow the right groups and you'll be able to see it. All you need to do is search up your uni followed by free food and it should pop up. Okay, something I want to point out is that some campus food have specials at the end of the day. So usually you might see in a typical time of day, they're roughly around $13, but around 4 to 5 p.m., they might be selling for $5. This is especially the case for my uni at UNSW at the Ainsworth building, where they'll have $5 specials of green curry and rice at 4 p.m., which is awesome. So that was all. I always use that as a substitute for my dinner when I needed to study late that night. So if you're someone that needs coffee to survive, I suggest you get a keep cup. So the reason why I tell you this is that most cafes on campus give you a discount whenever you use a keep cup. And if you think about it in the long term, you're making your money's worth and saving a lot more money. Plus, it's quite environmentally friendly. So yeah, that's sort of pieces of advice that I have for you. So if you like this video, make sure to subscribe so you can see more of my content. Laters. Where you'll see a lot of occasional, where you,